there is a requirement for new households to actually have some ability to store rainwater. Or you can do it as a community. You don't have to do it as a household, but a new development does have to have some capacity to capture stormwater and then use it for some beneficial uses, not generally in the house at this stage. It's generally for outside. Once you... The connection between that the community has between the quality of the water, disease, and everything else is very strong, and that's why the potable reuse scheme, which generates water of a higher quality than what goes into the dam naturally, has undergone such intensive testing and has such extensive validation and verification and monitoring procedures, because all the data, all the evidence shows that the community is extremely sensitive to, as they should be, because it's a major factor, to hygiene issues associated with water. And so I think what we're already seeing it, is collection of this sort of water and its use for outside. The shift is now saying, well, couldn't it be used for things like toilet flushing, for some, if you like, lower-end uses, as opposed to drinking in the household? And that's the next step, but it takes you up in a requirement in terms of validating the quality of that water to a significant level. And the debate is whether you're better off doing that in a decentralised model or in a centralised model. And the answer is it will vary depending on the community. I think we will see move in that direction. I think it will be slow to come into the household when you have other options. I think that's the...
Pat.
Oh, sure. I think a big issue with the feasibility of anything like this is the seasonal pattern of rainfall. The worst case is a Mediterranean climate. You get lots of rain in the winter when there isn't really that much demand. By December, the tank's empty. You're not going to get any more rain for another 3 months. And so really, you're getting almost no value out of having a water tank. Summer dominance is a little bit better, but what you really want is year-round rainfall so that you're continually refilling and empty, refilling and using the store rather than filling it once in the wet season, leaving it full throughout the wet season, emptying at the beginning of the dry season, and then having to draw on the main supply after that.
And the final word, I think, we'll leave to Pat.
Thank you. In response to the question, and in addition to what Paul said, it's not just new developments, it's any significant renovation you're required to put in a rainwater tank now. And they encourage you to connect it to your toilet already. So that's extending what we call the fit for purpose sort of principle with regard to water use in the house. So it is happening to some extent, but probably not to the extent that you did in Lay. There are also some potential sustainability impacts. Pumping and lifting water every time from a local tank into your house is not as energy efficient as using a pressurised collective system. So it gets back to Paul that in some instances collective is better, some instances decentralised is better. And if I may, I can answer the question with regard to raising the dam. We build dams in gorges or valleys, so think of them as a triangle. Every metre you put on top means a fairly large area across that. To give you a worked example, and this is me trying to jiggle my memory from about 8 years ago, they're currently raising the Hens Dam about 8 metres vertically. The dam wall may be, dam embankment, I beg your pardon, maybe 50 metres wide. They have to build around about 500 metres of embankment so that the water that is now at a high level doesn't tip over the next saddle. So often you get a situation of diminishing returns, and I think that's probably the situation we're at with Wivenhoe already. So no, please don't fill it up to 200% with water, because you'll leave no flood mitigation capacity.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that does bring us to a close. The irony is not lost on me standing here as I'm looking out on a sun beaming down on the Brisbane River, just literally out our window there. And this, of course, is Customs House, which was used to collect customs excise for people that were essentially taking stuff up and down the river. So we are a river city, and one of the consequences of being a river city is that we do have to deal with water. I'm sure you will join with me in thanking our four expert panellists. We do have small tokens which certainly do not compensate them for their opportunity cost. They are some bottles of water from the Brisbane River, which was sampled on about January 12th at St Lucia. Ladies and gentlemen, will you please join with me in thanking our four speakers? I will pass those gifts on as they leave the stage. Can I remind you that our next event will be on May the 12th. It will be with Professor Ian Harper, well-known economist, ex-chair of Fair Pay Commission. Should be a really interesting session. So that's Thursday the 12th. Thank you indeed for your continued attendance and support of the University of Queensland. Enjoy your day.